Junior, I knew you would pay more.
But what we didn't and couldn't agree is that there'd be a war now, could we? My customer. I will get you every last... Help!
Watch your clothes. Keep!
Vespula's got someone else's protection now.
Really? Who's that be?
The King of Beggars made a deal with Junior. This is his turf now.
Didn't hear nothing about that.
But you have heard what Bedlam does to people who cross him. Or you need a demonstration.
Come on, Fritz. Boss wants it that way. It's how it's gotta be.
Thank you. Oh, thank you. To think there are men who'll help a stranger out of the kindness of their hearts.
Not entirely out of kindness, and you're not entirely a stranger.
What are you? Oh, I know you. You're that witcher took Dandelion out whoring. Gerald, right?
Not Gerald. Geralt.
Oh. Dreadful sorry.
Explain something if you don't mind. You say I took Dandelion out whoring.
So he said. Claimed I was his one and only. But he fell in with the wrong folk. You and that dwarf who always looks like a cow licked him. Said you two were a bad example. Wine, women.
Song. He picked that habit up from us, too. Gotta have a word with him. What do you think? Where could Dandelion be?
Probably out whoring. That horse pheasant. That lying scoundrel.
Ouch. What did he do to get your goat?
Same thing as ever. Prize bullshitter came back, saying it was till death do we part this time. And no more than a week passed before I spotted him in Harborside, strolling with some trollop on his arm. 'Twas the last straw. All those questions about the washerwomen at the bathhouse, then this. I beat him black and blue and threw him out on his ear.
Dandelion ask you about other washerwomen? Not terribly subtle even for him.
Maybe he likes some sudsy.
Maybe. But what did he ask about, exactly?
Oh, this and that, really. What's it like at the bathhouse? Have I got any friends there? What are their working hours? I don't know. Maybe he's looking to hire one for his tavern. Maybe I got all in a huff for no reason.
This woman he was with in the harbour, who was she?
Claimed she was his niece from Kovir. Ha! Horvir, more likely. Corset so tight her eyes were popping out her head. His too, come to think of it. An artist or a whore. Doesn't much matter as they're one in the same.
Thanks for your help. Listen, when I find Dandelion, anything I should tell him?
No. I mean, tell him he's a two-faced snake, but it would be nice if he dropped by.
And all the easy to find witches already.
How can I be of service?
What are you, sir? Seal it.
Boars. It takes a great deal of arrogance to call a pyre salvation. Like supper again.
This baronet's love, Let's Villa.
Shouldn't interest you. The baroness don't mingle with just anyone.
Don't worry. I'm here to see your chambermaid, Molly.
Out of the way. Baroness is riding out. Be gone.
Geralt of Rivia at my doorstep? Surely this is no chance encounter.
Greetings, baroness. Greetings, general. You're right. I'm here for a reason.
There's no mistaking you. But for etiquette's sake, Mary Louisa Lavalette, an Imperial General and a Witcher meet. And know each other. Surprising.
Yeah, we had an opportunity to, talk when the Emperor summoned me to Vizima.
Had you run afoul of Var Emrys? No. You'd be long dead if that were so. It seems, then, that you share some interests. But I shan't question you out of doors. Will you accept my invitation? Tell me what brings you here.
Looking for a girl named Molly. Heard she works here.
My maidservant. I'm afraid she's currently at the home of my dear friend Patricia Vagelbud.
Perhaps Geralt could accompany us. He could speak with Molly at the races.
Is that something you'd consider, Witcher? Care to partake of some sophisticated diversion?
Well, if Molly'll be there.
On our way, then.
We've arrived.
My father owned a similar estate in Bruges. As a young girl, I'd travel there often to ride.
Shall we look at the horses? Do you like horses, Geralt?
I guess so. Called every horse I've had Roach.
The grey mare is Cantarella, sired by Cahir, the champion from Vol.
Grey's a nice color. For horses, too.
My coin's on the black stallion, Nemrod, purest Nilfgaardian stock.
Surprised he didn't salute you, General. Seem to know your horses.
No is not the word. Morvran's a true expert.
I find them to be far more honest than men. Must say, I'm curious how you manage in the saddle, Witcher.
Mostly just try to stay in it.
What would you say to a little race?
Not what I came here for.
Don't make me beg, Witcher. Tell you what, win, and I shall give you my finest saddle, made in Nilfgaard proper of beautifully tanned leather.
Why not? Wouldn't mind seeing if your knowledge of horses translates into riding skills.
Well said. So, which steed do you choose, Witcher?
Heard tales of Zeracanian horses. I'll ride the bay.
I'll not ride with you, but I shall bet on a steed. Nemrod will win, no matter the rider.
Cantarella for me, then. I see no point in delaying this. Let's begin.
Riders, ready!
I adore the speed, the rush
of air!
Let's see what you're made of. Don't spare me.
What a thrill! A beautiful victory.
Thanks.
For one for whom every horse is a roach, you carry yourself exquisitely in the saddle. My congratulations.
That is yours.
Now, could I talk to your chambermaid, milady?
Ah, yes, Molly. That is why you came here, after all. The portly young woman. That's her.
Speak to her. And you must find us when you're ready to return to Novigrad. We'd be delighted to join you for the journey.
Nothing hurts as much as life.
I'm Molly, milord. Wish to see me?
Call me Geralt.
Geralt? That Geralt? The one Dandelion's rescued time and time again?
Mm-hmm. Wouldn't be here if not for Dandelion.
Told me all about your adventures. How he'd ready you for battle with his songs. How he tamed the Cairn by playing his lute.
I meant that literally. Dandelion's why I'm here. Came to ask you about him. Know where he might be?
No. Sadly, I haven't got a clue. We've not seen each other in ages. The Baroness don't approve of our acquaintance. Says Dandelion's a good-for-nothing layabout. Can you imagine? But... or maybe his sister could help you. Such a nice girl.
Any chance you remember your last conversation with Dandelion?
Of course. He came to borrow some coin for a barge.
What? Why do you need a barge?
To take me on a romantic cruise of the canals by the light of the moon. Said there'd be strawberries and that wine with the bubbles, and he'd sing me arias. But I've not seen him since.
You do realize Dandelion doesn't have a sister?
Sure he does. Saw him himself. Funny, she don't look like him at all. Blonde, for starters. Maybe they've different fathers.
Mm-hmm. Different mothers, too.
Maybe. But you could see he cares for her. Looks after her. The way he carried her packages and...
Know where I can find her, Dandelion's sister?
I know. Whenever I ask Dandelion when we visit her, he'd grow all quiet and then change the subject.
Thanks, Molly.
Wait. Before you go, I've got a request. Dandelion told me once he'd show me his etchings, but he never did. I'd so like to see him.
Won't be too hard to convince him. He loves showing off those etchings to anyone he can.
Oh, that's wonderful! Thanks, and good luck to you on your search.
Geralt, there you are. Shall we return together?
Gladly. It's a long way to Novigrad. Road ought to seem shorter with some company.
I'd say the same. Well then, let's go. And here we are. Thank you for your company.
Likewise. See ya. Excuse me. I'm looking for Mirabella.
I am she. Wait outside. Class is in session.
I'll wait.
It won't take long. It turns out he'll not come after all. Why not? A rat bit him, and he's caught a fever.
Where'd he get bit?
It hurt him much.
Will he die?
Don't die, you rat, stupid.
Yes, you do. Just the other day, I saw a witch hunter tell a man, you rat, and then he killed him.
Liar, that's enough. We're done for today. Gather your things and go home. I'm
gonna be a butcher when I grow up. Wonder if the rat hatchery is there.
Like as not.
How do you know?
Mum says that if he but catches a cough, he's as good as in the grave.
Now can we talk?
Yes. What do you want?
I know you saw Dandelion recently.
Oh, yes. Longest afternoon of my life.
He read you his poems?
No. He perused the illustrated guide to fungi.
Maybe. No. Won't even try to guess why he wanted to do that.
Mold. That was his interest. When his hand abandoned my knee to point at a figure of penicillium, I knew the fire between us had died. Permanently.
Found a poem Dandelion wrote about you. Portrayed you as an unusually talented individual.
Really? Did he mention my poetry? Horses have always fascinated me. I've always longed to extol their noble beauty. Did you see any of my work at Dandelion's? Mere exercises, true, but I'd be curious to know what you thought of them.
No. Didn't see any.
Gee up! A snakely whip rose skyward. Jee-haw! Crack! She reined the beast in. The stallion danced betwixt her thighs. Lather bathed its chinny-chin-chin.
Sorry, don't know much about poetry. See Dandelion after the fungus incident?
No. I even considered granting him another chance. His heart of hearts is pure gold. He simply needs a bit more discipline in his life. But he never came back to see me. So I thought if it's done, it's done.
Thanks for your help. Farewell.
Oh! pathetic.
Got so fucked up once. Blood came out of ears.
All the way to the garden.
What, did you catch him?
No, no. Driving is slippery, the bugger, as quick as a tomcat.
Civilization.
What do you want?
Want to see Rosa Varatra?
Oh, mate, if you only knew what I want. Miss Rosa don't see just anybody.
I'm Geralt of Rivia, a witcher.
Soon as Miss Rosa turns into a Striger, I'm sure her papa will send for you. But she's not showing any symptoms yet, so I venture you're not needed. On your way now. Thanks, we ain't looking for no witcher.
What do you want? Rosa Varhatra is expecting me, supposed to give her lessons in swordplay.
Come with me. Miss Rosa awaits. Don't you realize what you've got yourself into?
Hope so too.
Miss Rosa's got a downright beastly temper. Shows no mercy once she grips a sword. Grab a wooden one. Take care not to hurt the little miss. You'll earn the ambassadors and follow me.
You're my new instructor. Well, well, Papa clearly went out of his way this time. Wood, to start with. I must know your worth.
You're gonna make me wait.
Why bother with two swords when you can barely handle one? Oh, damn it! Well fought. You're much better than the last one.
I'm not actually your swordplay instructor.
Really? Then who are you? And how on earth did you get in?
I'm a witcher. I'm looking for...
A witcher? That's splendid. I always wanted to meet a witcher. This is so exciting.
Incredibly. But we ought to discuss that another time. Came to ask about your rhetoric tutor, Dandelion.
Rhetoric tutor? Good one. That is why Papa hired him, but not at all what the bard had in mind. He mostly played his lute and sang for us. I believe he thought he was wooing.
Mean he wasn't? But you had some sort of relationship?
If you call him chasing after me a relationship. Even so, there was nothing between us. Seems my sisters had a bit of fun at our expense. But enough chatter. Stand and fight. I demand a rematch. Rat it! You're quick! Why bother with two swords when you can barely handle one?
Well, how long are you gonna make me wait?
When you can barely handle one. Oh, damn it!
Well, if you're not an instructor, you should certainly be one. Fancy giving me a few private lessons?
Can't rightly refuse a request from a lady.
What are you two lovebirds whispering about?
You asked about my relationship with Dandelion? Well, here's the mix-up's mastermind. Edna Va'atra, the greatest mischief-maker north or south of the Yoruga.
Wait a minute. Mean to say Dandelion mixed you two up?
On occasion, yes. But then Rosa would quickly set him straight. If you'd shut your catty mouth for a moment, dear little sister, I could explain. Edna sent Dandelion some love letters. She signed my name. Conceited as he is, naturally he fell for it. I was left to repel the aging bard's advances. Rosa, I had the best of intentions, you know that. I felt you needed help taking the first step. You blushed every time he sang a ballad.
He'll next sing at your funeral if you don't stop it right now.
Calm down, ladies. No poet's worth two sisters nipping at each other's throats.
Especially not this one.
Listen. I just want to know one thing. Either of you seen Dandelion lately?
Edna might have. I certainly have not. My dear sister, I would never spend time alone with a man for whom you burn with a secret passion.
Burn with passion? For one who incessantly praises another woman's talents? Afraid I've more sense than that.
Bet sophisticated young ladies like you know a bunch about politics.
We've picked up a few things. What would you like to know?
Emperor continuing to push north. Courtiers must be ecstatic.
His confidants must be. But Papa says that's not likely to last much longer.
Why not?
Papa says the war's disrupting trade, and people are tired of financing the Emperor's adventures.
Wonder how the war's going. Any outcome looming?
Papa says much depends on Radovid, and on who captures Novigrad first.
What's Novigrad got to do with it? Free city. Never taken sides. Always stayed out of conflicts.
Oh, even children know Novigrad's home to the world's largest fleet. And they say the city's treasury's bursting with enough to equip two armies.
Changing subjects. What are two young Nilfgaardian aristocrats doing in Novigrad?
Dying of boredom. Papa's a diplomat. He also has many business dealings in Novigrad. He's a member of the Trade Corporation. Takes us along everywhere he goes, and must then find us new tutors in each spot. And so in Novigrad, the task fell to the poet Dandelion, Rosa's betrothed.
Edna!
Dandelion act any different lately? Notice anything strange?
Strange? Not really.
It's no use, Geralt. She's so enamored, she'd hardly notice if he turned into a werewolf. Edna!
What?
You needn't pretend he followed convention. Remember when he took us to the cemetery?
Rhetoric lessons in a cemetery. Unusual even for Dandelion.
We set out to visit the graves of celebrated Oxenford professors. He ended up quizzing us about Margrave Henkel.
Who?
Eccentric old coot. Died recently. He'd apparently been an important and generous patron of the arts as a young man.
Who'd Dandelion sing about? Know anything about her?
I believe she's a poetess, or Trebaritz. Very skilled and exceptionally talented, of course.
This woman. Not a local, right?
I seem to remember him praising her melodious Kaviri accent. Makes sense. He referred to her as Kalonetta a few times. Bizarre names are common in Kavir.
Gotta ask Zoltan about this Kalonetta. Been a pleasure, but I've got stuff to take care of.
Exceedingly nice to meet you. Please come again. Well, can I expect any more lessons in future?
Awfully convincing, miss. Wonder where you learned it. Name the time and place.
House here, tomorrow. Same time as today.
See you then.
See you, Master Witcher.